16,000 police officers on the streets of London last night. Vigilantes were there too. Groups of ordinary people took it upon themselves to keep their communities safe. Tom Parmenter has the details.
Listen, mate, we're the Enfield anti-rioting squad. You want to riot our term, then we'll just have it, mate. We're here to smash you up. You want to riot our place, we'll riot you, mate.
This is the backlash. People across London are now prepared to act. With their communities under attack, they've chosen to become the guardians of their streets. Whatever the police or the government think of it, these local patrols do have local support.
I've got, you know, back the police up 100%. Their hands are tied by left-wing lunacy civil rights laws. Simple.
And do you not think, though, that it is just antagonistic to come out on the streets?
No, it's not. We've had enough because the police aren't doing their job.
So therefore, what happens if you see looters tonight?
We will do what the police should be doing and why
them. Apprehend them and we'll contain them until police do come and arrest them. Yeah?
They need to feel afraid, not families. I've got a family. Not families and kids crying in their own houses, feeling unsafe because the police are not containing and crushing the stupid uprising of a load of hoodies who are just bums. Simple.
We love you, Enfield. We do.
This group in Enfield stopped when they heard this driver's windscreen had been damaged. They took descriptions of who the driver thought had done it, just in case they spotted them. But these groups are made up of different people with different agendas. In Eltham in southeast London, the English Defence League were involved. The peacemaking crowd were actually the ones being policed. In Southall in West London, hundreds of Sikhs came together to protect their temples and property.
Brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, come together with us and say, let's solve out the problems without undue violence and causing distress to each other, which then takes it onto a further level, causing further violence and distress.
The group in Enfield patrolled their streets late into the night.
The police appreciated we'd been decent. It wasn't bags of beer or people screaming and causing trouble. We acted decently, responsibly. We got cheered on by other pedestrians, other local people, and the police cheered us on as well, and the fire station, everybody did. And hopefully this is going to cap it. This is the last of the kids, of people coming out of thugs and wrecking stuff. We won't tolerate it. We'll look after our own streets in a responsible way. Hopefully every man around London is going to see this tonight, and every gentleman's going to be doing the same thing. The riots are going to stop tonight. That's our aim, and hopefully we've done it.
Where this movement may lead, or what might happen if they do hand out their own punishments, is still not clear. But these people feel empowered to defend themselves and those around them. Tom Parmenter, Sky News, Enfield.
Peter Powell's a former senior Metropolitan Police officer. He joins us live from central London. Good morning to you. What do you think about this idea of people taking to the streets, as we saw there, to protect their neighbourhoods?
I think it's inevitable, sad. I, for one, and many listening to us right now, are getting rather fed up feeling sorry for the police. We want to be proud of our police. I'm also getting increasingly frustrated reading letters from retired colonels in Tunbridge Wells saying we should go out there and shoot them and so on. The vigilante part of it, though, is the inevitable consequence of an enfeebled police service which is struggling to understand whether it's a police service or a police force. That's a major issue. So many senior police officers were the best one in the world. Are really signed up to the doctrine that force is a tool of a last resort, which isn't true. But what we saw last night in London was for the first time in many nights of the police returning to its historical roots of being a police force. If, however, vigilantes continue to grow for the understandable reason that they perceive to be that the police are so enfeebled, that is a major problem, but I fear inevitable.
Well, Deputy Assistant Commissioner Steve Kavanagh was quite critical of the vigilantes this morning. He said that they take the resources away when the police are trying to fight the rioters.
I understand what the Deputy Commissioner is saying, and I've got every sympathy for it, but I think you've got to pull back one more layer. Why are they doing this? Why are vigilantes on the streets? Why are mosques being protected and so on and so on? The reason being is the perception, and it's not inaccurate, that the police have not returned to their true values of prevention before detection. In other words, preventing these events. Manchester police didn't do a bad job last night, I must say, but I think it's no good saying blame the vigilantes. The vigilantes are out there because they think they're not being protected by the police, partly because the police, as I've been talking about, have an almost a sort of mild form of corporate schizophrenia. This issue about, are we a force or a service? For too long, they've seen themselves perhaps as little more than a tool for social engineering. Others, and I'm one of them, think that their obligation is to enforce the law impartially above all else.
Well, let's look now at how well prepared the police are. We can hear from Tim Godwin. He's the acting Met Police Commissioner. He arrived at the Cobra meeting a short time ago, and he said that police are well prepared for more violence in the capital.
Obviously a lot.